this is so shit then. I feel like most of these bugs, you don't even have to test them to see if they're gonna bug you. You know ahead of time. To this goofy freestyle, Link.
Since killing zombies is such a big part of this game, we invested a lot of time into making their death animations more dramatic than simple ragdolls. We had a professional stuntman on a motion capture stage perform about 100.
Oh, we've seen the video, beginning of this video. We didn't watch the whole thing, though.
Different kinds of weapons and hit from different directions, like from the front or behind. We then combine these mocap animations with the physics-driven ragdolls. The result is a really cinematic experience, with zombies that stumble for a few steps into a wall, then slide down the wall and collapse. It's the best of both worlds.
Guys, okay, one small comment. Chat. If it's as simple as boy comes from this side, do this animation. How come games don't spend the time getting multiple animations for sides of getting hit from? I don't get that.
It's the best.
It's that easy to just record one thing and just... Even lazy. You're wearing a suit, you're on set, you're in a studio, you're there. Why don't you just do it? You already get it up. Expensive? Why?
XQCL.
I would love to do that. Well, I would do shit for free, man. You're doing death animation for somebody? Dude, I'd give them fucking 300 different animations. Fuck it. Are you kidding? It's also so fun.
We treat the infected horde as a major character in Left 4 Dead and spend a lot of effort in making their movements believable.
I'll show you some.
Stagger around, cough, vomit, fight amongst themselves, lean against walls, sit on the ground, and lie down as part of their wandering behaviors. When they see a survivor, they become enraged, taking off in a full sprint, leaning into their turns, trying to get to their victim.
That looks good. Oh my god. Okay.
We wanted to express this rage in their faces as well. So we found efficient ways for each member of the horde to make intense facial expressions.
A standard mock-up per second can be anywhere between $5 to $25 per second. It's super expensive.
Wait, per second? Oh, because of the work they have to do behind the scenes afterwards, right? Not because of the actual acting and the product. What are you saying? El Sazo, you're back! This is a 90 steel box, man. What's up, man? Oh, that looks fun.
Mocap animation are not just costly money wise,
they
take a lot of space in a system's memory and hits the performance.
Oh.
Then there's a lot of shenanigan regarding animation blending and stuff. I could talk about it for hours.
It was a challenge to create this diversity of looks for common infected and take advantage of unique clothing or uniforms in specific areas.
That's kind of lame.
For instance, lots of TSA agents are spawned in the airport, hospital patients around the hospital.
What if you could automate it?
Cops in the streets, office employees in the offices, etc. It helped to reinforce the sense
3D
of
animation student here.
We wanted to add further variety to the Left 4 Dead campaign, so we extended this notion when we added the Mud Man.
This is a good video, I enjoy this.
The clown, the construction worker, and the riot cop.
Oh, sorry, I'm so dumb. I skip for no reason.
3D animation student here for a nerd explanation. Mock-up animations need to be edited and fixed. Pause tracking isn't one.
That's what I would think, yeah.
along with the fact that you need to script every animation in game, as well as the previous Donner said mock-up is expensive.
Yeah, but what if you had an AI or some shit you developed that was smart enough to understand how wrong it is, right? And kind of fix it. With certain parameters, it would put the data of the mocap and it. Parameters like what is humanly possible, whatever, and it kind of fixes.
In Calgary, life is different. We know. We've been here for over 17 years. We've seen young people build their lives and families grow. We know our success is yours, whether it's your first house or moving into your next dream home. Our proven marketing strategies are here to help you because our clients come first. We do what's best for you. I'm Justin Haver of Justin Haver & Associates with RE/MAX First, the leading RE/MAX team in the country. Visit us at justinhaver.com.
Sensorena gives players a mental training experience like never before. Anticipation, psychological strength, court awareness. We make sure that next time you are facing that game-changing decision again, you will make the right one. Sense Arena, your inner game.
Fixes it then. I wanted this chance fucking, but fuck you guys. I'm whatever, dude. This chat is fucking stupid.
You need making an AI like that would be more expensive.
Well, you have to do it once though. What if you were a company that had the AI and you developed it for like $1 billion? You could just send to everybody.
Since players spend the vast majority of their time shooting the common infected, we wanted to improve the feedback and visceral nature of this experience. In Left 4 Dead 1, we provided only the ability to shoot off limbs. Now, in Left 4 Dead 2, there are 43 unique ways to damage an infected. Because many of these wounds are non-fatal, players are able to wound an infected more than once, resulting in about 780 possible damage combinations.
We're watching this. Interesting video, man. This shows you the level of depth of games that you can't really appreciate them because you're not really looking at it. It makes a game what a game is to a bunch of small things, but you don't really realize it.
XQCL.
It can be from depth of audio, auto engineering. It can be animations, the range of animations. The fidelity of what you do that affects the game is all the things.
I just wanted to say I smile.
This is so shit, dude.
Left 4 Dead had a level of depth for gore and animation greater than most games I've seen. Compare that to modern day games and they are really lacking in effort.
Oh, that was cool!
Studios are more concerned with getting a game released than actually making it good now.
Then the ragdoll is kinda sick.
And littered with breakable and movable objects.
Chat, is this made in Source or not? Isn't Source super good though for like props and shit? That's gonna how I You know, after playing like Gmod and fucking fucking Portal. So many items, so many props, they all move.
This restaurant was one of the first areas we populated with tables and chairs. In early playtests, the survivor would pop a boomer, and the resulting explosion sent tables
That's
and
cool.
chairs flying
I like
everywhere.
That.
It was a great effect. We decided to furnish a few more areas like this, so that more players would be likely to experience it.
Fun. Cause I feel like if a big company, if a big corporate is behind you pushing you to release your game as fast as possible, this ship is at the bottom of the list and this never gets released. This never makes it into the game, ever. If you're getting pushed to release, this is like... That's a little lame. Any shadows? Any?
Left for dead.
Does anybody have a shadow here, guys?
Flashlights to illuminate the environment. These shadow casting light sources not only add surface richness and provide important visual depth cues, they tie into gameplay.
Immersion.
Because a player's flashlight is attached to his or her weapon, the light becomes pointed off to the side when reloading or performing a shove attack. Like so many of Left 4 Dead's game mechanics, this encourages cooperation, as players know they may be left in the dark if they choose to reload at the wrong moment.
Oh, that I actually forgot about that. I guess I'm too fucking dumb to notice. I'm the type of player who just get mad it's happening, I don't know what the fuck is going on.
In playtests, people were often confused by certain events and elements in the game. The addition of musical cues helped distinguish these events and diminish player confusion.
That's smart.
Players who leave the music on are treated to a variety of subtle audio cues that not only deepen the horror experience, but make them better players.
We base the music on what the player is actually experiencing, and not on what we want them to experience.
Fair enough. Actually, good game dev. Holy. Okay, this is shit. That's what my hands. Dude, her running animation, dude.
Keep the music appropriate to each player's situation and the person. The music engine is a complete client-side multi-track system per player that is completely unique to that player.
This is Fly One approaching the trash heap.
Stronger than Flight 1, careful on the descent.
He's noticed my descent. This might be the end. Tell my wife I love her.
Fucking hands.
good to know.
One difficulty with the tank is that since we offset his incredible toughness by slowing him down a bit, when tank battles occur in large outdoor spaces, he is far less.
This is why when approaching the trash heap,
Roger that flag one careful on the descent.
He's noticed my descent. This might be the end. Tell my wife I love her.
I killed both of them today, so we're chilling. Wait, that was sick though. Oh, I remember that. Oh, come on. Guys, am I wrong in thinking that there are shortcuts that you can do when you're making a game that you can achieve something like this, but without doing that? I feel like if you're gonna make a shortcut to do it, then you can, there's other ways to do it. I think that's like really bad. It's like super rush something, I don't know what it is.
There are hundreds of infected types mobbing the player in Left 4 Dead. There are only four survivors. To make sure these four stood up to close scrutiny over many hours of playtime, we decided to use photographic reference of faces and wardrobe details.
That was unnecessary.
We started out by casting four individuals who fit the general design concepts we had created for our characters. The talent was guided through a matrix of facial expressions.
This,
created
that, and this,
a complete catalog of movements and expressions for each character's face.
What I like about this though?
This is an
the idol.
For our modelers and animators when they start to recreate these expressions in three-dimensional models.
Yeah, good idols. Jesus, wait a minute, hold up. What? I thought she didn't like it or something, I don't know. I wonder, man.
To be attractive and worn down at the same time. She needed to be tough and able to hold her own, even though she's occasionally terrified.
Flashlights off.
Her readability was also something we had to take into consideration.
While we were developing Left 4 Dead, we shipped a game called TF2. And Team Fortress 2 talks a lot about things like rehierarchy and retrieving the elements that you need to have in a multiplayer environment. We also wanted to push harder on the horror direction, so one of the last things we're doing with the game before we ship it is we're redoing all of the survivor characters.
Four characters were designed as a unit, so that while I stand out together,
hey,